Hi, I'm Caleb Horst with CellScale Biomaterials Testing. Today I'm talking with Heleen Fehervary and Julie Vastmans in the lab of Nelly Famai and Jost Vandersloten at KU Leuven in Belgium. Thanks for joining us, and I wonder if we could start with just a question of explaining an overview of what your research is at KU Leuven.
Within the soft tissue biomechanics group in KU Leuven, we look for aneurysm diagnosis improvement, but also how to treat those aneurysms better, which is, in our case, our primary research. But another part we're also looking at is in developing safer and better head protection. So we're also trying to model bridging veins and brains and everything inside your head to get to better standards for helmet design.
And to understand these tissues better, what type of criteria do you need to evaluate, and how do you understand these tissues?
So the tissue that we get is from surgery, from patients. So we need a reliable characterization of these tissues. So that's actually the first focus of our research, a reliable mechanical test. And then secondly, we also want a reliable data processing and parameter calibration. We're trying to see how can we improve the testing conditions, but also what is the best way to process your data to get the most accurate or reliable material parameters that can be used then in numerical models. And as such, the outcome or the reliability of these numerical models can be improved.
What features of the biotester have been really useful for getting the data that you need?
So as Heleen already said, is that our samples are very small. So as they are from surgery, we get samples from about 1 centimeter size. So we have small samples, so we need an easy mounting for those types of samples. So the biorigs are a good way of doing that. And we want to mimic the in vivo conditions as closely as possible. So we also need to test them under water, in this case, physiological fluids, and preferably on the correct temperature, which is body temperature.
What are some of the things you've learned by collecting all this data?
Currently, the diagnostic criterion for aneurysms is the diameter, but we feel that mechanical properties are very important as well. So we can see from our mechanical tests on our tissues that we can actually distinguish two groups. We can see aneurysmal tissue that has been operated on, so that has reached this diameter criterion, but the material properties are still quite okay. And the other group, the mechanical properties have deteriorated, and it's actually close to rupture. We feel that the mechanical properties need to be integrated into this diagnostic criterion.
What are the future directions of your research? What are some things you're going to be doing moving forward from here?
So we have already been looking at how to improve the diagnosis of aneurysm. And the next step we want to look into is how to model and quantify how those aneurysms grow, but also how a certain treatment will affect the aneurysm growth. And for that, we are developing animal models in which we can induce dilatations of arteries, and that we can mechanically test at different stages to see how those growth and remodeling processes take place, so that we have a reliable way of verifying our numerical models.
How have your experiences been with the biotester? How have you found it for accomplishing what you needed to do for your research?
What we especially liked, it has some smart designs such as the biorigs, which we like very much, but also how the mounting is easy by moving up the temperature bars.
Well, it sounds like your research is being very successful, and I want to thank you both for taking the time to talk with me today. And for those of you watching, thank you also for taking the time. And if you have any further questions or comments, please contact CellScale.